Hello, I'm Arindam Ghosh. As I have already introduced myself, I'm an assistant professor in the Department of English, Krishna Chandra College, Jhetampur, Birbhum. And today is actually my sixth and perhaps my last lecture on Goblin Market, which is in your fourth semester English Honours syllabus. So in the previous lectures, I have already introduced you to the Victorian literature, to the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood, and of course to Christina Georgina Rossetti, who was the sister of Dante Gabriel Rossetti, one of the founder members of the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood. And at the same time, I have also introduced you with the notion of the Victorian morality, moral absolutism that prevails in the Victorian period. In the past three lectures, I have analyzed the text of the Goblin Market. I've done a comprehensive textual analysis of Goblin Market. As you all know, it's a 567 line narrative poem about the adventures of two sisters, Laura and Lizzie, with the river goblins. Now, in this present lecture, I will discuss some of the very important issues and some of the probable questions regarding Goblin Market. As you can see in the screen, the structure of the Goblin Market is not that complex. It's a rather simple structure. It begins with that of the temptation of Laura by the goblins, and then there occurs the fall of Laura, which ultimately leads to the consequences, and finally leads to the rescue of Laura by Lizzie herself through an act of self-sacrifice, and ultimately it leads to the redemption of both the daughters, Laura and Lizzie, and ultimately it ends with Laura and Lizzie beginning a new life through marriage and begetting children, etc. So, temptation, the fall, consequences, rescue and redemption, this kind of structure is followed by the poem Goblin Market. Now, we will discuss some of the very basic concepts which will help us in unraveling the Goblin Market. The first is the patriarchal mindset as reflected in the Goblin Market. Now, what is patriarchy? The word, the etymological origin of the word patriarchy, have originated from the Greek word patriarchos, which means the father. Patriarchy, archy, means rule. So it actually means the rule of the father. So patriarchy is basically a social system in which the political leadership, the moral authority, the machinery of the states, and every other important organs of the state is generally controlled by the men. Okay, so it's basically a system that privileges men. In many societies, patriarchal system is equated with patrilineal system, because the inheritor of the property will be the male only and not female. In fact, throughout the entire world, the right of the recognition for the inheriting the right of the property has been granted women after in the beginning of the 20th century, only around 930. In fact, women got their right to vote around 1910-1920, first in New Zealand in 1908. So as you all know, that this right to vote, right to inherit properties, these basic rights were not granted to women up to the beginning of the 20th century. So our entire world, the entire societies throughout the, across the whole world was essentially patriarchal, where men hold most of the power. And it is almost impossible for women to reach the same status as men. So in Goblin Market, the goblins perhaps represents this patriarchy, which have always visualizes women as a commodity. This commodification and objectification of women occurs throughout the Goblin Market. নারীকে যে পণ্য করে দেখার যে প্রচেষ্টা সেটা গবলিন মার্কেট জুড়ে রয়েছে এবং সেটা যে পুরুষতন্ত্রের প্রতীক দ্যাট ইট ইজ আ সিম্বল অফ দ্য পেট্রিয়ার্কি অনলি অ্যান এক্সটেনশন অফ দ্য পেট্রিয়ার্কি হ্যাজ বিন শোন ইন দ্য গবলিন মার্কেট বাট মাচ মোর ইম্পর্টেন্ট দ্যান দ্যাট সিজি রসেটি ক্রিস্টিনা জর্জিনা রসেটি অলসো সারেন্ডার্স টু দিস পলিটিক্স অফ দ্য পেট্রিয়ার্কি হাউ বিকজ we must recognize that it's a poem written in and published in 1862 and hence the character of the Lizzie has been built in a very didactic way by Christina Georgina Rossetti and so that in fact the various politics of patriarchy which talks about the boundaries of the women which talks about that women shouldn't go outside in the night these things have been embedded in the structure of the poem in fact Lizzie who is an ideal and archetypal representative of quote unquote good woman is constantly saying her sister through various moral upbraidings that please don't go there sister please don't go hither so this form of instructions which almost voices patriarchy is embedded inside the poem of the Goblin Market so in this sense Goblin Market is both a proto-feminist poem proto-feminist in the sense that feminist movement officially began around 1920-1910 but it's a poem written much before than that and hence it anticipates some of the characteristic of the of the feminist movements and hence it can be called a proto-feminist text and which tries to resist some of the structures of the patriarchy but at the same time it also surrenders to the patriarchal misconceptions because the poem also creates certain gender roles kichu specific gender role create korche assignation of the gender role je kon kon jinish gulo ke nari korte pare ki ki ke purush korte pare narir kaaji hocche essentially victorian society te ডোমেস্টিক কাজকর্ম দেখা এবং লড়াই এবং লিজি পুরো পোয়েম জুড়ে তাই করছে দে আর হ্যান্ডলিং দ্য কাউ দে আর হ্যান্ডলিং দ্য বিজ অ্যান্ড প্রোডিউসিং হানি সো দিজ ডোমেস্টিক ওয়ার্কস হ্যাজ বিন জেনারেলি সিন অ্যাজ দ্য আইডিয়াল ফর্ম অফ ওয়ার্ক ফর আ ওম্যান দ্য কনসেপশন অফ দ্য ভিক্টোরিয়ান কনসেপশন অফ দ্য কোট অ্যান্ড কোট এঞ্জেল ইন দ্য হাউস সো সি ইজ অ্যান এঞ্জেল একজন পরীর মতো তাকে বাড়ির মধ্যে রেখে দাও সে শুধুমাত্র বাড়ির মধ্যে বাড়ির কাজই করবে বাইরে বেরোবে না অন্য কাজ করবে না যেটা পরবর্তীকালে একটা চেঞ্জ হয় আফটার দ্য ইন্ডাস্ট্রিয়াল রেভলিউশন আফটার দ্য এক্সপ্যানশন অফ দ্য ইন্ডাস্ট্রিয়াল রেভলিউশন কিন্তু ইন জেনারেলি ভিক্টোরিয়ান হাউস হোল্ডের মধ্যেই এঞ্জেল ইন দ্য হাউস গুড ওম্যানের কনসেপশনটা চিরকালই বিলং করতো তো লড়াই এবং লিজিকে এইভাবেই পোর্ট্রে করেছেন যে লড়াই ইজ অলমোস্ট আ ফলেন ওম্যান ইন দ্য ভিক্টোরিয়ান সেন্স অফ দ্য টার্ম সে পতিতা নারী প্রায় পতিতা হয়ে যাচ্ছিল গবলিনদের হাতে পড়ে কিন্তু লিজি তাকে রক্ষা করল তো এই যে রক্ষা করার ব্যাপার এই যে প্রোটেকশনের ব্যাপার এটা একটা এসেনশিয়াল ফিমেল সলিডারিটির কথা এখানে ক্রিস্টিনা জর্জিনা রসেটি বলেছেন কিন্তু এই ফিমেল সলিডারিটিও অনেক ক্ষেত্রেই পেট্রিয়ার্কি দ্বারা কন্ট্রোল ফলে আমি বলবো দ্য গবলিন মার্কেট ইজ বোথ অফ প্রোটোফেমিনিস্ট টেক্সট অ্যাট দ্য সেম টাইম দ্য ট্র্যাপিংস অফ দ্য পেট্রিয়ার্কি ইট অলসো সারেন্ডার্স টু দ্য ট্র্যাপিংস অফ দ্য পেট্রিয়ার্কি বিকজ আলটিমেটলি অ্যাট দ্য এন্ড গবলিন মার্কেট এন্ডস উইথ লরা অ্যান্ড লিজি বোথ বিকামিং গুড হাউস ওয়াইভস সো দে হ্যাভ সারেন্ডার টু দ্য ইনস্টিটিউশন অফ ম্যারেজ অ্যান্ড মাদারহুড এইভাবেই এই পোয়েমটা শেষ হচ্ছে ফলে পুরুষতন্ত্র পুরো কবিতাটা জুড়েই অপারেট করছে I have already discussed, not discussed with you, but with the six semesters, that what is the basic difference between sex and gender. I have already told you in the second semester while discussing about Bravely for the Queen. So while sex refers to the biological and physiological differences between men and women, gender refers to the social and cultural differences between men and women. So gender is basically socio-cultural construction while sex is essentially biological. Sex is given at by birth but gender is learned through socialization. Samajer theke shekha. Sex is therefore cannot be changed unless and until artificiality. But gender can be changed because it is essentially a sociocultural conception. So gender roles and expectations may differ across time and culture. American conception of gender will be essentially different from the Indian conception of gender. Iranian conception of gender will be definitely different from the English conception of the gender. কারণ নারীর স্বাধীনতা বিভিন্ন দেশে বিভিন্ন। একজন নারী কি করতে পারে, একটা নারীর একটা সোসাইটিতে কি রোল, সেটা বিভিন্ন সোসাইটি বিভিন্নভাবে দেখেছে। লেন্সটা, দেখার যে লেন্স, চশমাটা, সেটা প্রত্যেকটা সোসাইটিতে আলাদা। এর ফলেই জেন্ডারের কনসেপশনটা আলাদা হয়। অ্যান্ড হেন্স ফ্রম দিস সেক্স অ্যান্ড জেন্ডার উই উইল মুভ ইন টু দ্য জেন্ডার রোল, দ্য জেন্ডার স্টিরিওটাইপিং। হোয়াইল জেন্ডার রোল অলসো নোন অ্যাজ a sex role or is a form of social role encompassing a range of behaviors and attitudes that are generally considered acceptable, appropriate or desirable for people based on their biological or perceived sex. And hence, gender actually created conceptions like masculinity and femininity. Again, purush ba nari, naritto ba purushotto ki hobe, seta amader society thik kore diyeche. And hence, feminine stereotype will be emotional. A female will always cry. She will be very much submissive, sympathetic. Essential qualities of the motherhood will always be there. Jehetu bola hoy je quote unquote mera to maer jat, tai tara khub tolerant hobe, cooperative hobe, faithful, supported hobe. Egulo amader samaj toiri koreche ei politics ta, jate essentially purushderke kono bhabei সিম্প্যাথেটিক হওয়ার বা স্পন্টেনিয়াস হওয়ার বা ইমোশনাল হওয়ার এই ব্যাগেজটা কোনোদিন বইতে না হয়। মেল মানে এসেন্সিয়ালি লজিক্যাল, র্যাশনাল, অ্যাগ্রেসিভ, চিভালরাস, ফিমেলদেরকে উদ্ধার করবে। সেখানে কোনোদিন নায়িকা কোনো একটা সিনেমাতে নায়ককে উদ্ধার করে না, নায়ক সবসময় ভিলেন, তেরোটা ভিলেনকে মেরে নায়িকাকে উদ্ধার করে। এটাই হচ্ছে জেন্ডার স্টিরিওটাইপিং, assigning stereotypical role to the male and the female. Chirokali male mani essentially independent, competitive, he'll be the boss and the decision maker. Female mani always faithful supporter. Conventional ideas like mard ko dard nahi hota, purushan na ki jantrona hoy na, dekhbo chartola bari upor theke fele dile jantrona hoy ki hoy na. Phole ei je bibhinno dhoroner gender stereotyping, gender roles created by the society, our patriarchal, patrilineal society, they have created these notions of the masculinity and femininity. This particular poem, Goblin Market, also falls into the trap of this gender role because Laura and Lizzie have assigned typical, archetypal and stereotypical gender roles that they will essentially as a spinster will see the domestic activities and then later will when they will move into the their motherhood and the when they will surrender to the institution of marriage, they will essentially play the role of a mother, a good quote unquote good mother in the Victorian context. So ei je puro gender role, gender stereotyping, ei ta kintu amra Goblin Market e khub bishon bhabei dekhte pacchi. I've discussed with you what is proto-feminism. Proto-feminism is a philosophical tradition that anticipates modern feminism in an era when the concept of feminism was still unknown. When the concept of feminism was still unknown, proto-feminism is actually identifying the traditions and texts which anticipates feminism, which anticipates theory of feminism like emancipation of women, like the difference between sexuality and gender, like the politics of the patriarchy. For example, around 24 centuries ago, Plato, according to Elaine Hoffman Baruch, for the first time said that the total political and sexual equality for the women, he talked about the political and sexual equality of the women. So in Plato, we can detect some proto-feminist element. Italian-French writer Christine de Pizan, the author of the books of the City of Ladies and Epistle to the God of the Love, generally Simone de Beauvoir, again bikkhato feminist, existential feminist, take first woman writer hisebe dhore jini prothom denounce koren misogyny ke. Misogyny mane hocche hatred towards women. So Christian de Pizan can be considered as a proto feminist writer. You have read Vindication of the Rights of the Women. by Mary Wollstonecraft, the mother of Mary Shelley. So, তাকে অনেকে proto feminist writer বলে. So, in this sense, Goblin Market can be called a proto feminist text. So, now we will move into some of the symbols in the Goblin Market. So, in the Goblin Market, women's hair, as I've already said, the golden hair of both the Laura and the Lizzie, is the symbol of their purity and health, both the spiritual and the physical. So, hair, this in this particular poem has been considered, the golden hair especially, has been considered as a symbol of purity and health. Bishuddhata ebong tader shasther lokkhon hocche ei golden hair, sonari chul. And at the beginning of the poem, Laura and Lizzie are both described as having golden hair, which is a very desirable color during the 19th century, blonde color, and one that was often associated with youth, beauty, purity in literature of the time. So Laura's hair in particular might also be red as an allusion to Petrarch's Laura. Petrarch is an Italian sonneteer. Throughout his entire life, he wrote sonnets to Laura, dedicated all his sonnets to Laura. The beautiful and golden haired idealized woman, immortalized as the love interest in the 14th century poet sonnets. Rossetti was very much familiar with Petrarch, and hence she can actually incorporate allusions to his poetry and to her poetry by alluding to the 14th century Italian master. And within the 19th century culture, hair had great symbolic significance and value. You know that the locks of hair were exchanged as tokens of love. You have read Rape of the Lock, that Lord Peter is forcefully trying to grab the hair of the Belinda. যদি বেলিন্ডা তার চুলটা কেটে দিত লর্ড পিটারকে, তাহলে সেটা হতো অ্যাজ এ সিম্বল অফ অ্যাকসেপ্টিং দ্য লাভ. এখানে ফোর্সফুলি এনক্রোচ করছে হেয়ারটাকে, ফলে দিস গোল্ডেন হেয়ার যেটা এক্সচেঞ্জ করছে লরা, থ্রু এক্সচেঞ্জিং দিস গোল্ডেন হেয়ার লরা ইজ গেটিং দ্য ফোরবিডেন ফ্রুটস অফ দ্য গবলিন ম্যান. সেটা এক্সচেঞ্জ করছে এই তার চুলটা. It becomes actually a kind of monetary transaction. যেখানে নিজেকে লড়া পণ্য হিসেবে বিক্রি করছে. লড়া has transformed herself into a kind of commodity. নিজেকে পণ্যে রূপান্তরিত করছে. So locks of hair was a very important symbol in the Victorian period, and locks of hair were exchanged as tokens of love and kept as mementos of the dead. So the act of giving away her precious hair in exchange for indulging in the sensual pleasures of the goblin's fruit thus aligns Laura with the figure of the fallen women. So this is a picture of Laura and the Lizzie here, Christian Rossetti's Goblin Market by Winifred Knights, and we can see how Laura's hair is being exchanged by the goblins. Another very important symbol in this particular context of the poem is of course the goblin men's fruit. The goblin men's fruit is a very complex symbol that it represents different kinds of desire and temptation throughout the entire poem. So these fruits actually represents temptation and desire, and the fruit represent a desire for things that are forbidden, exotic and sensual. It alludes to the Christian myth of the fall of the men, where Eve have eaten the apple. The tree of the have excited Adam and incited him to eat the fruit of the forbidden tree. You have read already Paradise Lost. So the goblins present the fruit to Laura on golden plates and describe it using sensuous language, emphasizing its taste, color and juiciness. So there is clearly a sexual dimension of Laura's desire for the fruit, especially evident in the descriptions of her eating it. And she sucked and sucked and sucked the more, and sucked until her lips were sore. So Asia at Adbhut addiction in eating the fruit. Tar kotha kintu bar bar amaderke Christian Rossetti bolchen. And Lizzie similarly recognizes the fruit as an object of desire, but she perceives it, it has some dangerous qualities. And and hence she actually warned her sister against eating this kind of food. Now the goblin men, who are the goblin men? The goblin men, I have introduced to you, with you the figure of the goblins. Goblins are basically dwarf-like figure. They are monstrous figures appeared in various European mythologies and fairy tales. But in the context of this poem, they have appeared in various forms of the animals like rat or cat or wombat. So they are basically mysterious villains of the poem. Where they come from, is never specified. But each morning and evening they call out in order to tempt young women into purchasing and eating their fruit. The goblins seemingly exist only to harm women, delight in tricking young women into eating their fruit and then abandoning them, causing great misery. Although they can be sly and persuasive, they are also vicious and brutal. We have seen the molestation of Lizzie by these goblin men. They savagely attack Lizzie in a way that resembles almost sexual assault when she refuses to eat their fruit. The goblins are thus symbols of temptation, and the dangerous sexual appetites of men and their behavior reflects societal fears about how women become fallen. That these goblins are essentially the agents of agents behind the reason of the fallen women has been portrayed by Christina Rossetti. So in this way, the archetypal figure of the European monsters have been portrayed as villainous figures who are responsible for the fallen women. In this way, Christina Georgina Rossetti has depicted the goblin men. Now moving into the themes of the poem, a very important theme of the poem is the temptation, the theme of the temptation and of the fallen women. Temptation, karud dara, desire dara, attracted hawa, take temptation bole. So goblin market is a very complex poetic allegory about sexual temptation, especially. And writing in the mid-19th century, at a time of strict societal expectations regarding women's behavior, Rossetti was intensely interested in the plight of the fallen women. Because I have already discussed with you, Rossetti also worked in the Highgate House, a kind of organization which works for the fallen women, for the prostitutes and other women. So those women who by society standards were perceived to have given it to the temptation of engaging in sex outside of the marriage and who were subsequently shunned from the society. So Rossetti allows Laura to avoid the typical fates of the fallen women in the 19th century literature, however, which are death, exile and transportation to the colonies. I have already discussed to you that in the 19th century, the fate and the destiny of the fallen women is either death, exile or transportation to the colonies, or she should begin the business of the prostitution. But Rossetti actually allows Laura to avoid these typical fates, and in doing so, Rossetti seems to suggest that fallenness is only a temporary state rather than a stain that remains on a woman for the rest of her life, and that complete rehabilitation and reintegration into her community remains possible. So fallenness ke ekta temporary fate hishebe dekhiyechen Rossetti. Ami barbari boli je keno fallenness Victorian morality essentially ei fallen women ke promote kore. Koi purush to kono din fallen hoy na, karon mane essentially purush ra ki sexually assaulted hote pare na. Keno hote pare na shotti amar jana nei, amar gyaner seta bai. কিন্তু বারবারই এই যে রসেটির লেখার মধ্যে ফলেন উইমেনদের কথা আসছে, রিহ্যাবিলিটেশনের কথা আসছে, রি ইন্টিগ্রেশন অফ হার ইন টু দ্য সোশ্যাল লাইফের কথা আসছে, এটা কেন বারবার আসছে? কারণ সমাজই এরকম একটা সিস্টেম ক্রিয়েট করেছে যাতে ফলেন উইমেন ফলেননেসটা এসেনশিয়ালি উইল বি কানেক্টেড উইথ দ্য আইডিয়া অফ আ উম্যান, উইল নট বি কানেক্টেড উইথ দ্য আইডিয়া অফ আ ম্যান, কোনোদিনই হবে না। তো এইখানেই ঘটেছে সবচেয়ে বড় সমস্যাটা। and Laura's rehabilitation is made possible by her sister Lizzie. So in this way, in the Goblin Market, Rossetti is dealing with the theme of the temptation and of the fallen women. Now we will discuss about the role of the women in the Victorian society. Why this particular theme is very important in the context of Goblin Market. We can see that Rossetti actually reflects on the role of the women in the Victorian society in the Goblin Market. Because the poem critiques the unfairness of society's double standards by showing how they put women at a disadvantage and then challenges them by allowing Laura to achieve a happy ending despite her transgression. However, both Lizzie and Laura's ultimate redemption involves a return to the motherly duties and caring for the next generation of girls. So ultimately, both the Lizzie and the Laura have accepted a patriarchal role of surrendering to the institution of marriage and then again performing the motherly duties and caring for the next generation of girls. So Rossetti is ultimately affords a distinctly gendered view of the society. She is actually following a stereotypical gendered role upholding with the society in which women occupy and find fulfillment within very specific domestic roles. So another very important theme lurking in the Goblin Market is the valorization of the theme of the motherhood. Motherhood ke bhoyongkor bhabe proshongsha kora hoyeche ekta onno store niye jaoa hoyeche. That the fate of the women is becoming mother has clearly been portrayed and projected in the Goblin Market. The familial role of the sisters is carried out through the projected relationships of Lizzie and Laura, and the role of the ministering mother is depicted through Laura and Lizzie at the end of the Goblin Market. So, and their husbands, but the name of their husbands have never been mentioned in the poem. It's actually ends with the Laura and Lizzie's warning to the daughters about the dangers of the goblin men and their tempting fruit, and how a female solidarity, how a female bond, a female union can be built in order to resist this form of patriarchal politics and patriarchal power has been described in the Goblin Market. Goblin Market shesh hocche, Laura ebong Lizzie a typical gendered role nijederke surrender korche through marriage and motherhood. Arekta khubi important theme Goblin Market er context is the theme of salvation and sacrifice. There are plenty of biblical allusions throughout the text of Goblin Market, plenty of biblical allusions, where Lizzie is constantly being compared with Christ or Christ-like figure, like with Mary, for example. And Laura is being constantly compared with Eve, the eternal figure for temptation, who has been tempted by Satan in eating the fruit of the forbidden tree. So Rossetti uses these biblical allusions to compare Lizzie with Christ, whose sacrifice saves humanity from death. A radical decision, given that Victorian society did not treat men and women as equals. It was quite radical in comparing Lizzie with the Christ. And Rossetti has also assigned various forms of qualities like bravery, self-sacrifice to Lizzie. Okay, and hence it is quite radical on that time, on 1862, of assigning of comparing Christ with Lizzie, or comparing Lizzie with Christ. And contrary to the dominant beliefs of a time, Rossetti seems to suggest that braving danger in order to help fallen women, who were often vilified by the society, is what makes a woman Christ-like. And ultimately, in overcoming her fear, Lizzie sets an example for the young women of the next generation, including Lizzie's and Laura's own daughters, of the way that women should care for another woman. How a woman should stand beside another woman. For there is no friend like a sister. The poem ends with this famous lines, for there is no friend like a sister. Your narir shobtheke bondhu, her sister. These are some of the illustrations. illustrations by Alan Raskin, Laughed Every Goblin. This is another, this is an illustration probably portrayed in 1970. This is another one, suggesting the purity and power of the tears. Okay, tear has been constantly compared with the pearl in this particular poem. So this is also another figure portrayed by Alan Raskin, 1970. So there are many paintings on Goblin Market, illustrations and paintings painted for the first time by Rossetti, from Rossetti to Raskin and others. The plenty of illustrations, and I have designed my whole PowerPoint by using these figures. So these are some of the very important 5 marks and 10 marks question that you can prepare for the Goblin Market. The first important question is the title of the poem, Why Goblin Market? It refers to the goblin men, the monstrous European fairy tale figures who are dwarves and who has been portrayed in the negative light, the agent of chaos, the agent of the suffering of the women, the man who sexually assaults Lizzie and Laura, and at the same time they have been equated with the word market has also been placed after the goblin, and market means actually commercialization and commodification and objectification of women. Narike jekhane ponner shonge tulona kora hocche, jekhane ei goblin men ra ei market create korche. So ei poem ta, why the title Goblin Market is appropriate to write about that. Contrast the character of the Laura and Lizzie, they are foil. You have to contrast these two figures, where Lizzie is a much more robust character. She is resisting constantly any form of temptations of the goblin men. Laura is not. এই জায়গাগুলো দেখাতে হবে, এবং লড়াই এবং লিজির মধ্যে ক্যারেক্টারের যে ডিফারেন্সটা সেটা দেখাতে হবে. লড়াই, লিজি ইজ বিং কনস্ট্যান্টলি কম্পেয়ার উইথ দ্য ক্রাইস্ট লাইক ফিগার, হোয়াইল লড়াই ইজ বিং কনস্ট্যান্টলি কম্পেয়ার উইথ ইভ, এগুলো দেখাতে হবে. কন্ডিশন অফ দ্য ভিক্টোরিয়ান উইমেন ইন দ্য সোসাইটি অ্যাজ পোর্ট্রেড ইন দ্য পোয়েম, দ্য প্রেডিকমেন্ট অফ দ্য ভিক্টোরিয়ান উইমেন, ভিক্টোরিয়ান মরালিটি, অ্যান্ড হাউ উইমেন ইজ লোকেটেড ইন দ্য ভিক্টোরিয়ান এজ, সেটা নিয়ে বলতে হবে. Goblin Market as a text of lesbian erotic fantasy. There are 3 words. One is, for example, homosocial, homo erotic, and homosexual. 3 stages of this form of third gender love. Now, what is a lesbian social? For example, in a society where there is a brotherhood or a form of sisterhood between 2 men and women, two men or 2 women, then it can be called lesbian social or lesbo social. But in this particular context, there are various scenes in which Laura and Lizzie are intimately connected with one another. We can see this, especially the fruit sucking episode, or especially the sucking of all the fruit juices from Laura's body, from Lizzie's body by Laura. So these all things actually reminds us about a form of lesbian erotic fantasy. Shetai Goblin Market kano is a text of lesbian erotic fantasy can be a question. And of course, symbols used in the poem, be it the golden hair, be it the goblins, be it the fruit juices or various exotic fruits. So these are the various important symbols of the Christ, the symbol that borrowed from the biblical allusions. Eigulo prottekta kotha likhte hobe. 5 marks এর সিগনিফিকেন্স অফ দ্য গোল্ডেন হেয়ার আলাদা করে পড়তে পারে, ফিগার অফ দ্য গবলিনস পড়তে পারে, থিম অফ স্যালভেশন এন্ড স্যাক্রিফাইস পড়তে পারে, সিম্বল অফ দ্য ফ্রুটস ইন দ্য পোয়েম পড়তে পারে. সো দিজ আর ভেরিয়াস স্পেসিমেন কোয়েশ্চেন, এগুলো যে পড়বে করে মানে নেই. এই প্রশ্নগুলো আসতে পারে 10 মার্কস এবং 5 মার্কস কোয়েশ্চেন্স হিসেবে. ভালো করে পোয়েমটার সামারিটা প্রিপেয়ার করবে. ইউ শুড প্রিপেয়ার দ্য ক্রিটিক্যাল অ্যাপ্রিসিয়েশন অফ দ্য পোয়েম, সেটা মোটামুটি প্রিপেয়ার করতে পারলে যে কোনো প্রশ্নেরই উত্তর দিতে পারবে. সো থ্যাংক ইউ. হিয়ার আই এন্ড মাই লেকচার্স অন ভিডিও লেকচার সিরিজ অন গবলিন মার্কেট. দিস ইজ মাই 6th লেকচার. আই উইল মুভ লেটার ইন টু দ্য চাইল্ড হ্যারোল্ডস পিলগ্রিমেজ লেটার অন, পরের ক্লাসে হয়তো আমি চাইল্ড হ্যারোল্ড পিলগ্রিমেজ নিয়ে আলোচনা করব. থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ. স্টে ওয়েল, রিড ওয়েল, and stay good at this very bad time of COVID-19. Thank you. Bye.